Sure. We have completed around three types of isomerism: optical isomerism, conformational isomerism, two types of isomerism we have completed. Now today we are going to discuss one more type of isomerism, and that is called as geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism. Sometime also called as cis trans isomerism. Now for every isomerism there are certain conditions. Like for optical isomerism, a compound must contain chiral carbon atom. As well as there are some elements of symmetry should be there. There should not be some elements of symmetry. Then only that molecule will show optical isomerism. For conformational isomerism, there must be presence of carbon-carbon single bond. Because presence of single bond allows the free rotation. That free rotation will give change in position of the atom or the group which are attached. And you can get different types of conformers. In the same way, if somebody want to show geometrical isomerism, so there are also certain conditions. This isomerism is shown by an alkene or which contains carbon-carbon double bond. If there is a presence of carbon-carbon double bond, there is first condition. There must be a double bond should be there. Because presence of double bond will restrict the rotation. This carbon and this carbon will not allow to move. The free rotation about the carbon-carbon double bond will be restricted. That is essential. That is first condition. There must be carbon-carbon double bond. Then only the free rotation will not be allowed. And the group which are attached to this carbon, they will fix. Then that double bond carrying carbon means this carbon which carries double bond, this carbon which carries double bond, double bond carrying carbon must attach to two different atom or two different groups. This is second most important conditions in order to show a geometrical isomerism. Well, the double bond carrying carbon must attach to two different atoms or two different groups. If these two conditions are satisfied by your molecule is ready to show cis and trans or geometrical isomerism. Just remember this condition, and now we will see, I will write some molecule on the board and let's see whether this molecule shows geometrical isomerism or not. So first molecule number one. For example, it's a general example. C, double bond C, A, and A. Look at it. This one example. Look at it. There is a carbon-carbon double bond. Condition number one is satisfied. But the condition number two is not satisfied by this molecule. This carbon, which is a double bond, is attached to A and A, which is similar atom. This double bond carrying carbon is also attached to AA, means similar atom. This will not show. Means this is an example, if you want to say a particular example, look at it, this is ethylene. The first member of alkene family. So here, the double bond carrying carbon is attached to, look at it, similar atom. Ethylene will not show. Now, let's take second example. C double bond C, I will write A, here I will write A. Now I will write A here, now I will change one group, one atom to this carbon. Now can this molecule show geometrical isomerism? Again the answer is no. Why? Because again there is a double bond, there is a carbon-carbon double bond is there. But this carbon is attached to A and B, means it is similar, two different atoms. Yeah, two different groups are there. But this carbon is attached to same atom, AA. This will not. If you want to see this example, look at it. CH3, CH, double bond CH2. Look at it. Same example, propene. If I write this propene in this way, C double bond C, this H and this H. Look at it, this two carbon and then this H and this CH. Look at it. there is a carbon carbon double bond, and this carbon is attached to similar atom, but this carbon is attached to different. We want both double bond carrying carbon attached to different atom or different group, then only it will show geometric closeness. Again, this example also failed. Now let's go to the condition number 3. Example number 3. What happened to the example number 3 now? In this example number 3, whether this molecule can show or not. Now I will write C double bond C. Now this is A, now this is B, now this is A, and now this is B. Now look at here. Immediately we will say, yes sir, it will show. Why? Because first condition, a carbon carbon double bond. Second condition, this carbon which carries double bond attached to different atom, as well as this carbon also which carries double bond attached to different atom. Means both double bond carrying carbons are attached to different atoms or different groups. Means it can show. If you want to see that particular example, look at here. 2-butene. Look at here. This is a very famous example, 2-butene. Now I will write here carbon carbon double bond. This is that carbon which carries double bond. And this carbon is attached to H and then CH3. This carbon is attached to H and then the next is CH3. Look at here. Double bond carbon carbon double bond. And both double bond carbon carbon bond of this as well as this attached to HCH3. HCH3 means they are attached to different atom or different group. Yes, this can show. This can show. So I hope so. Now if any molecule will come to you and he will ask, I want to show geometrical isomerism, then you put these two conditions before you. If this condition will be satisfied, then I don't mind. You can show geometrical isomerism. Both double bond carrying carbon. There must be carbon-carbon double bond. And both double bond carrying carbon must be attached to two different atom or two different groups. So ethylene fails, propylene fails, 1-butene also fails. But 2-butene, this is 2-butene, beta-butene. This can show because it satisfied both the conditions of geometrical isomerism. So now, I hope so, now conditions are clear. Now once conditions are clear, then it will be asked, write down its cis and trans form. So how to write down its cis and trans form, and why it is called cis and trans isomerism? Why it is called cis and trans isomerism? Look at here now. This is now conditions are clear. Now, I will write again to example of 2-butene. Look at here, CH3, CH, double bond, CH and C3. Molecule will be given this form. But you are supposed to write in the cis form and trans form because this molecule will satisfy. Now, this molecule will exist in the two isomeric form. In one, geometrical isomers, what it is called cis, and the second geometrical isomer that is called trans. So, how to write cis and trans? First of all, write down the carbon-carbon double bond. Write down those carbon which carries double bond. So this carbon I have written. Now this carbon is attached to H. And then next is attached to CH3. Then this carbon is also attached to H. And then attached to CH3. Look at it. You can see there is a carbon-carbon double bond. So this carbon, there is no free rotation is permitted. And the groups which are attached to this carbon, now there is a single bond. When there is a single bond, then you can rotate. So sometimes similar groups come on the same side. Sometimes similar groups come on the opposite side. You can see this is similar, this is similar, this is similar, this is similar, similar groups present across the carbon-carbon double bond are on the same side. When the similar groups or atoms are lying on the same side of the double bond, such isomer is called cis isomer. Cis means same side, close. And if somebody wants, if you write cis, it's very easy to write down the trans. Keep the position of one group on the carbon-carbon double bond as it is. Just flip the position of the second group of the carbon-carbon double bond. Look at here, I will just keep this group as it is. I will keep H as it is, CH3 as it is. Now, the group which is attached to this carbon, I will just flip, I will just change in their position. Now, I will write CS here and now it's here. That previously hydrogen was at the top, methyl was down, now methyl has come top and hydrogen. Now you can see the similar groups CS3, CS3 are on the opposite side. Hydrogen, hydrogen, they are on the opposite side. Where the similar atom or similar groups are lying on the opposite side, that type of isomers are called trans isomers. So, in exam, so many molecules will be thrown at you and it will be asked to you, find out which molecule will show and why. If it shows, then write down its cis form and trans form. So, I have, in front of me, four molecules was given, ethylene was given, propylene was given, 1-butylene was given, 2-butylene was given, but finally I chose 2-butylene because that satisfies the condition. Once it satisfied, then I have written its cis form and trans form. After writing cis and trans form, then explain why cis, why it is called trans. Then you explain what is the order of stability. Because these isomers are having different stability, different reactivity. If you see cis form generally less stable and trans form is generally more stable. One famous example of this isomerism shown by our natural polymer that is called as rubber. If you see rubber, the chemical name of rubber is chemical name is cis polyisoprene. This is the chemical name of rubber. It's a general name, not rubber, but its chemical name is cis polyisoprene. Means our natural rubber, it exists in the cis form. When I write cis, then I immediately remember, it is a geometrical isomerism. A geometrical isomerism, there are two isomers. If it is cis, means similar groups are on the same side. Trans means similar groups on the opposite side. So that is cis polyisoprene. And the trans form of the natural rubber is called another polymer, that is called gutta-percha polymer. This is trans form. So our rubber is existing in the two isomeric form. Our rubber is showing geometrical isomerism. When somebody is showing geometrical isomerism, there must be cis and trans. So what is the cis form of rubber is called? That is called cis polyisoprene. That is actually rubber. And the trans form of the natural rubber is called gutta-percha polymer. Between these two, this polymer, gutta-percha, trans polymer of natural rubber is most stable. Thermodynamically, it is most stable. Always remember what is cis and what is trans form. So, this is so, I hope so now, the condition and what is geometrical isomerism and what are the examples, if it is given, we can immediately distinguish which will show and which will not show. If it will show, then we can write its cis and trans form. In the same way, there is a very famous example called steel beam. Now look at here, this is formula CCH4, CH double bond CH, CCH5. This steel beam. You can see, there is a carbon-carbon double bond. Yes. Condition number one satisfied. Now this both double bond carrying carbon is attached to different atom, different groups. So as soon as the two conditions satisfied, we are able to draw its cis form and trans form. Now first of all, write down double bond carrying carbon. See this carbon. Then the groups which are attached, then it is H, and this is CCH5. Here also same, this is H, and then your CCH5. Look at it. This is your first one. This is the example. This one isomer, where you can see similar groups are lying on the same side. Same side means that is cis form. Now, when you want to write down the trans form, keep the position of one group attached to a double bond carrying carbon as it is. Just flip the position of second group attached to the second double bond carrying carbon. Now look at here. I will keep this group as it is. H and CCH4. Now this I will flip. This is CCH5. This is H. Now you can see this is called trans steel beam. So obviously between these two, the most stable geometrical isomerism between these two cis and trans, this is obviously trans form. You can see opposite side, similar groups are on opposite side of the double bond. So this is a famous geometrical, famous type of isomerism called geometrical isomerism. The same type of isomerism you can see in Beckmann reagent. Very famous example of reagent. Where also you can see cis type, same type of isomerism, say Central's isomerism, Bachmann rearrangement. So there are a number of examples are there where this isomerism it exists, which we call geometrical isomerism, say Central's isomerism. So please remember the way all conditions and their examples and how to write down the cis and trans form for this molecule. This is one time. Now, I will just briefly explain one more thing. Suppose there is a double bond is there, a carbon-carbon double bond is there and attached to two different atoms. Different atoms are there. All atoms are different. All groups are attached, all atoms or groups attached to double bond carrying carbons are different. Then such type of isomerism cannot be written. For that Z and E isomerism is the option. So this Z and E, how to write Z and how to write E, what is the condition, that part we will see later.